Welcome back to Out and About Today. We are cooled off and in the studio, and it's time to recap our amazing Pride 2016. I'm joined by Pride President Joey Leslie. Welcome back to the show.
Happy to be here. Thanks.
We teased that that Brent and Chuck would be here, but once we knew you could get on the show, I said, it's just going to be me and Joey.
Okay, so I got to have enough energy for all of us then,
that's right. Well, congratulations on an amazing 2016 Pride. I know in my circles, everybody just thought it was the best Pride ever, which is how it should be.
Good.
Let's start with the thank yous, because there's a lot of folks I want to make sure they get credit, because it's not all you. You didn't do everything.
No, not at all. It's hardly me. I have to first give a shout out to the amazing board members that I had the honor of serving with this past year and for several years, really, and the hundreds of volunteers it takes to actually make the festival and our other events happen. So I have to give a nod to all of them first and foremost. And of course, our sponsors, presenting sponsor this year, Bridgestone, as well as some others, Nissan, Coors, Delta, that came on. Couldn't do it without all that. It takes a lot.
That's right, and I'm guessing the board that continues will want all of them back.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
So we're just taping a few days after the big celebration, so I know all your numbers aren't in.
Right.
But tell me what you do know in terms of attendance.
Yeah, so I feel comfortable estimate right under 20,000, which is a huge new record for us. The Equality Walk, which got so much coverage and had so many people, it was right around 3,000, if not more in that. For the first time this year, Metro Police Department and Parks Department participated in that walk.
Right.
Amazing.
See
that. And so many corporate groups, other local companies, and just community groups. And, you know, it's just such a moving event. And to see the people, like, now up in windows above, like, waving, giving thumbs up, and just those sorts of things, it's just so cool.
I know. And we touched on it at the start of the show from the park, just the tributes to Orlando. That was really moving. And you saw that throughout the day, besides just the parade, the Equality Walk. Is there any talk that a parade might jump out from the Equality Walk, because it gets bigger and bigger,
right?
A lot more people on the sides watching, like you say, in the windows.
True.
So is the board consider that?
You know, it comes up, people ask us about it a lot. Nothing's off the table, but I'll say it's the walk and a parade are very different things. You know, the walk is like a very participatory, symbolic, let's see how many people can get involved and want to participate. You know, a parade would take it in a little bit of a different way. But even this year, a lot of people were saying, oh, did you see the parade? I was in the parade. So people are already kind of, and it's getting kind of bigger and a lot more, you know, props and, you know, people dressed up in it. Who knows what's to come?
So you talk about it. That's what you're telling us.
Yeah, and nothing's off the table.
I love that.
A different thing.
And, you know, a lot of people don't realize there's so much money out on a parade and not that much money in. But anyway, we're going to talk about that later.
Yeah, you know this from your experience in the past.
I do. So tell us what the takeaways were from this. What's the feedback on the festival?
Yeah, so, of course, let's start with the obvious negatives, because there were only a few, but it's too hot.
Right.
Maybe, like, the porta potties are not the most fun and wonderful, but we get that.
You can't control that. What can we do?
But widely positive feedback, which is great, you know, from people saying, like, I go to a lot of festivals or participate in festivals. This one was so well run and organized. Like, how do you guys do it? And we're like, well, that's good. You know, like, even though the walkies are going off in our ear the whole time, like, oh, but, you know, just minor troubleshooting things, but it did go so well. Shout out to our festival director, Jack Davis, for all of that. And like I said, literally over 100 volunteers who were on the ground the whole time, kind of making things go. But it was just amazing. Everybody loved it. Like, it was just a great energy all day.
It was a great energy. There was an army of people all around. Yeah. You could tell that it takes a huge force. So that there's some folks that just volunteer the day of. That's the only time they get involved, and that's wonderful. And then there's folks you need year-round, because when we were talking before we started taping, you all will be meeting soon to debrief. So I'm catching you on the couch before you've debriefed with the board.
Right.
When that process is starting, how do people get involved at this early stage?
Sure. So there's never a lull in our planning. It's a year-long thing. So like you mentioned, we'll have a debrief in a couple weeks and really see where can we take it from here? What do we want to do differently next year? And then our regular scheduled board meetings are the first Wednesday of every month. Those are posted on our website with location. And we encourage people to come. Those are open board meetings. You know, come and see if you're interested. And if you want to get involved, that's the way. And, you know, come to those meetings now. Voice your opinion. Tell us how you want to get involved, and, you know, now you've got about a year to really settle in and dig in.
And in 2 years, they may be sitting on the sofa, not a couch, and then telling us everything.
Yes, this could be you.
Well, it is so true. I don't think people realize that you can get involved from the ground up and end up running the show because not everybody wants to run it.
Yeah. This is, and I'll say, this is one of those boards where there's a lot of different ways to get involved in different boards. This is one where it's like, if you really want to have an active role and kind of like dig in, it's not like an advisory board where you say, here's my opinion and you know what, not that there's anything wrong with that, but this is just not, it's a very like hands-on kind of involvement, which is what I liked about it, which I think is why all of us are involved. And we literally, Friday night concert, all day Saturday, all of us were there the whole time. Like, cause you know, you want to see it come to life. You've been working for a year. So those are the kind of folks that we're looking for.
Right, and you know, Pride is in a position now that you're solvent, you're healthy, so you can, you have choices. With all that, bring some freedom, bring some choices. We only have a minute left. I want you to just speak on how social media changes the dynamic of Pride, because when we were doing the interview at the Pride Festival, I think you talked about people live streaming.
Yeah.
It's a whole different world.
Some live streaming going on, and a lot of just, you know, the day after, as I'm like kind of recovering, just looking through to see the coverage out there. It's so many stream, like now it's like, you know, of course we have our own photos, but just to see it from other points of view, like the people there, like capturing it and documenting it for you. And it's just so amazing to see like some of those candid personal moments from people.
It is.
You know?
Well, we're out of time. Thank you, Joey. Leslie, you're rolling off the... No, you're president-elect now, so we'll see you again.
No, I'm president now. I'll be past president. Oh, pass past the torch to Phil.
I mean,
Phil
president-elect Phil.
Yeah.
What am I saying? All right, well, thank you. All right, that's all the time we have for today. We'll see you next time on Out About Today.